to our first narrated flight video. This is the Skywalker X8 on the aerial system. What my project's entailing then is we're going to try and get a fuel cell flying in this. So we're going to use it as a fuel cell platform to test hydrogen fuel cells, propane fuel cells, anything else we can get our hands on. The airframe itself is made of similar to polystyrene type stuff. It's got three main spars in it, so it's fairly stiff. I've made modifications to the underside, which is all it is some fiberglass tape, which greatly stiffens the wing up, in particularly in windy flight, but more importantly an overweight flight, makes the handling considerably better. We'll have a look at what's in the aircraft first of all, because it's a little bit beefier than the normal setup. So rather than a 3 or 4 cell battery in the nose, we have a 7 cell. So it's a just under 26 volt battery, 4 amp hour. And at the moment, for a 10 minute flight, I'm using about 10% of the battery. So you're getting some pretty good endurance off that as it is. Moving back, we've got a 7.5 amp UBEC. Right at the front, far away from any sensors as you can get. We've got a spectrum maximum channel receiver, 8 or so channels on that. We're only really using 4, so you've got throttle, elevator, aileron, and then you've got your flight mode switch, which is the flight mode for the autopilot. This is ArduPilot 2.5 sat here. And we've got all the different flight modes set up at the moment. Not too confident on the navigation gains yet, but we're hoping to get that one tuned up today, along with giving it a go on a autonomous launch. As you can probably see by the movement, it's a little bit blustery today, so we'll see how good that is. The box next to it, all that is just an LED controller. I've just got some flashy LEDs on the wings and stuff to make it a bit more visual. As it turns out, on a day like this, you can't see it, so don't worry about that. Plate in here, which is where the Raspberry Pi is going to go, or BeagleBone, probably Raspberry Pi, because that's what I've got set up at the moment. And that's going to be the controller and data logger for the full system, which I'll show in a sec. Speed controller is an 85 amp Hyperion speed controller. Obviously, this is a high voltage one to take the 7 cell. And then on the back of the aircraft, we have a Hyperion 4025, which is an 15x10 prop. The reason it's so chunky is because we need that power to get in the air, particularly with it being a chuck launch. It's got to be airborne within, sort of, you're getting about 10 yards. But then in cruise, you can spin this rather chunky prop very slow and get some decent efficiencies off it. So the fuel cell side of things then is my mount. It's simply velcroed down. Velcro, best stuff for unmanned stuff, if it doesn't fatigue. This is a commercial off-the-shelf 100 watt horizon hydrogen fuel cell, so about 100 to 120 watts. It's not flown yet, so we're interested in getting this flying today. We're just doing weight testing to make sure that it will actually fly on that weight. And of course, we got a GoPro just to get some funky videos, and that's also what Mikey's using there to video me now. And the transmitter finally is a Spectrum DX8, just set up normal configuration, no Gucci stuff. So let's have a quick look at what we're weighing now. Wouldn't be the most accurate because of the wind, but you can get an idea. So just turn the scales on, so that's 0. So we're looking about 2.8, something like that. Take a bit of error because of the wind. And that is your operational weight empty, but including battery. So there's no dummy weight in there at the moment. Fuel cell there is looking about 1.5 kilos to just sort of between 1.5 and 2 kilos. And we've also got some standard weights here, 2 kilo and a 1. And we're going to try and fly with 3 kilos, simulating a 3 kilo payload, meaning you could fly with a 3 kilo fuel cell or 3 3 kilos worth of SLR camera or whatever it is you want for your mission. Okay, let's go for a flight.
Right, calm, come on.